At the end of this tutorial, you will be able to procedurally generate caves in Godot engine. First, make sure to download the Godot project I've provided in the description of this video. After unzipping the downloaded file, open up the procedural caves folder in Godot engine. This project consists of a simple scene containing a background image, a tile map, and a camera 2D. The tile map has already a tile set configured, containing an auto tile. Feel free to draw around in the editor as you choose. Now create a new node called cave generator and save it as cavegenerator.tscn. Additionally, attach a script of the same name. The idea is that we can attach this cave generator node to any tile map we have and it will automatically generate the cave for us. In order to generate the cave, we need to access the parent tile map. For that, we're gonna create a new variable called tilemap and we're gonna assign it to the parent as tilemap. We are already able to draw the cave in the editor, but this is a manual process. What we want is to do the same, but in GDScript. Let's start by creating a new function called setAutoTile that accepts an x and y coordinate. The responsibility of this function is to literally draw tiles in the world. When looking at the official documentation of Godot, the tilemap class defines a setCell method that we can use for that purpose. The setCell method requires various parameters we have to provide. Luckily for us, the x and y parameters we already have. However, we need to figure out a way to retrieve the tile ID as well as the autotile coordinate. The tile ID is basically the ID of the autotile we defined on the tile set contained by the tilemap. Now we are gonna call the setCell method on the tilemap object. For the x and y coordinate, we provide the arguments of the function. As discussed, the tile ID is accessible on the tileSet object that is configured on the tilemap. We just retrieve the first one there is, we just assume there will be just one autotile. We can completely ignore the next three arguments. We don't care about flip, x and y as well as transposing. The last argument is the coordinate on the tile set that can be retrieved on the tile map object. For the auto tiling to work properly, we need to do one more thing. We need to call the update bitmask area on the tile map. This is required so the Godot engine knows where to configure the auto tiling. Next, we're gonna create two new methods. We're gonna create a clear method that completely clears the existing tile map. And we're gonna create a generate method. In there, call the autotile function and provide 0,0 as a coordinate. Unfortunately, Godot won't automatically update collisions as well. Therefore, we need to call the update dirty quadrants method on the tile map. Within the ready function, now call the clear and generate method. In order to use our cave generator, we navigate back to our scene and we're gonna attach the cave generator scene to the tilemap as a child. Starting the game should now show a single cell drawn in the center of the screen. To generate the cave, we're going to use the open simplex noise implementation of Godot engine. The idea is that it will provide us a value between -1 and 1 for every single coordinate on the map. The open simplex noise object expects a set of parameters that we need to provide. We are going to create a set of export variables so we can configure them in the editor. Now create a new variable called simplex noise and within the generate method we're gonna configure our simplex noise object. For the seed I'm applying a little trick. The seed is normally an integer, but in order to not limit ourselves we're gonna use a string and simply use the hash code on it. Before we can generate the cave, we need to limit the size of the cave because effectively the tilemap is infinite. To solve that, we are going to create two new map variables, map width and map height, that specify the area where the cave should be generated. Therefore, we need to loop through every single x and y coordinate within that square in order to generate the tilemap. For every single position within that square, we're gonna call the setAutoTile method we previously created. Starting the game should now show a giant dark square, which is expected because we don't use the simplex noise yet. We need some sort of condition to decide when we draw the autotile and when not. Therefore, we're going to introduce a new export variable called noise threshold. With that threshold, we can actually now decide when we draw the autotile. For that, we are comparing that the value of the noise at the given position is smaller than that threshold. Starting the project now shows a generated cave. In order to update our cave structure on the fly, we're gonna create a new export variable called redraw with the setget method of called redraw. Within there, we're gonna simply call the clear and generate methods. When starting the game now, you can actually live edit the attributes of the cave generator. If you like this tutorial, let me know what you think and feel free to subscribe to this YouTube channel. See you next time.